السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Today I will take you back maybe 25-30 years ago to talk about our first visit to Baghdad, which was delayed for about 3-4 years after the safe haven had been created by the United Nations in Kurdistan, Iraq. And when we got the visa from Brussels, from the Belgium, through the Iraq embassy there, I traveled with my colleague who was a volunteer from United States of America, for Islamic Relief United States of America, and we landed in Amman to take the taxi or take a private car to take us from Amman to Baghdad. Credit goes to in this visa and the organization of that of the journey to the office manager of His Excellency Dr. Abdel Menem, who was actually the Minister of Islamic Affairs and Endowment, Miss Samira Al-Maadid, who gave us all the direction what to do in Amman, and then to go to Rashid Hotel, and it's actually to come to the ministry to meet His Excellency later on. So we did follow what she told us. May Allah bless her soul, if she's alive or not alive, in the different world. But she was very, very cooperative with us, and we will always call her at home to get her guidance. We arrived to Baghdad about 7, 8, 9 o'clock in the morning of the day. We straight took a taxi from the station to Al-Rashid Hotel. And when you step on the entrance of the hotel, you find on the ground the photograph, or the image of George Bush, the father, actually in humiliating to George Bush himself. So we stayed in one room, me and the Aftab in the room, and we've been trying for the following 2-3 days to visit His Excellency, the minister, but he was so busy. And we went to see some of our colleagues there, and one of the relatives or colleagues from UK who guided us to go and visit his family and to meet his father and his relatives there to give us some guidance. And we had one dinner, two dinner with them, and he told us, Sonny, don't play with exchanging your money in the black market, because this could be suicidal for you, because it could lead to a death penalty against you. We went after 2-3 days, not failing to do the organize the meeting with the minister. At the end of the day, we decided to go to the black market to chain the money and to go to buy the sheep against all the advices. We took the risk. We took the risk because the difference in prices, it was for maybe it's twice as much as in the black market to the price in the bank itself. Yani, it was 500 nearly or 400 dinar for a dollar in the bank, and was 900 dinar for the dollar in the black market. And we bought, and we used to carry it in a big black bag on our shoulder. When we wanted to buy the first lot, we have been fooled by actually the businessman. Then some Syrian businessman came, and he was selling his sheep, or he brought it from Syria, and he knew that we are actually amateur, and he started to give us guidance, and he became a good friend of ours. We went again to the house of Mr. Kazim, Haji Kazim, to have another dinner or another lunch with them, and we told him what we have done, and said, okay, may Allah help you, and we told him that tomorrow we're going actually to meet His Excellency the Minister. Because I was afraid of what might happen, of consequences of exchanging the money in the black market, I decided to make Qiyam al-Layl at that time in the room after Aftab slept, and I didn't know what to read in the Qiyam al-Layl. And I remember something to say, and I keep repeating it as an ayah for me when I was making Qiyam al-Layl. And next day we went to the minister, and he was very nice and very noble man, and of course the officers around him or his colleagues in the ministry wanted to take the money to make this difference between the black market price and the official price. And I told them, okay, well, you are too late, we have already bought the sheep, and this is finished. And the minister was very kind, considerate, and said, okay. Then they wanted us only to distribute the meat to the Sunni area. I said, no way. Sunni, Shia, Sabi'i, Christian, whatever it is you have, I will do it. And the minister, may Allah bless him, he also agreed to this, actually, and let us go. And we also talk from the minister some of the most important thing, which is a letter to allow us to transfer the meat from Baghdad to Basra and from Baghdad to Mosul, to Karbala, to Najaf, to Kufa, to Rawa, to Heat, to Ana, to Al-Anbar, to all these areas. And alhamdulillah, kindly, this gentleman, he did it for all of us and make our life easy. Then, what I am saying here, actually, at that time, the work for Iraq was very untransparent by most of the Muslim charities in the whole world. It was actually in the Middle East or in Europe and America. No reporting, no video filming, no photograph, nothing, because they were so scared to do this, so they could be penalized by the regime there. What we have done, after taking all this, we took photograph for every step that we were walking in this mosque, in this church, in this prison, in this everywhere. Not only that, we made an initial report of the distribution of the carcasses through with the partnership of the Ministry of Awqaf to different areas, even to the schools, to the hospitals, to al-Husayniyat, to the mosques and others. And we wrote big report by hand. We did not have a computer at the time, but we wrote it by hand. And we gave a copy to the Ministry of Qaf. We gave another copy to UNICEF, which were actually the humanitarian coordinator for United Nations there. Then we gave a copy to the International Committee of Red Cross there. So this was a transparency which allowed us to come back very proud of what we have done and to tell people this is what we have done, and this is the images, and this is the photographs. And this changed the philosophy of working in Iraq 180 degrees. We let all, not even all, most of not all, the organization in the West or in the East to follow our footsteps. Here the lesson is, be honest, be transparent, take the risk, and wait to get the right entrance to the country through the right channels. Because our work is not just to raise fund and to be the first to distribute the fund and to produce the aid material, but to keep the unity of the community and societies that we are trying to help, and to keep the status of the state that we are trying to help. With that, and this is what we have been doing when we did to in Sudan in 2003, when we decided to work in the south while we are working in the north at the same time. So there was a negotiation between both parties, and both parties agreed. So alhamdulillah, we managed to work on both sides up till now for the last maybe 17 years. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.